Welcome to the course on 5G New Radio, 5G NR. In this module, we will learn frequency bands supported by 5G New Radio. Low bands are frequency bands which are less than 1 GHz. At present, all the existing technologies such as 2G, 3G, and 4G operates on these bands. That means these bands are already occupied by 2G, 3G and 4G. 5G also supports low band. Lower side of mid bands are from 1 GHz to 2.6 GHz at present. 3G and 4G systems are operating on these bands. 5G also supports these bands. Mid band frequencies are from 3.5 GHz to 7.125 GHz. At present, 4G systems are operating on these bands. 5G also supports these bands. High band frequencies are from 24 GHz to 52 GHz. These are new bands supported by 5G. 2G, 3G and 4G do not support these high bands. These bands are also known as millimeter wave, as wavelength of these frequencies are in millimeter. So in summary, 2G operates in lower side of the band, 3G operates on lower side of the band as well as low mid bands, 4G operates on lower side of the band, mid band, and 5G operates in all the bands, low band, mid band, and also in millimeter wave. Let us look at how frequency bands are identified by International Telecommunication Union. So ITU identifies frequency bands for International Mobile Telecommunications, IMT. So mobile technologies are known as IMT by ITU. The countries who are member of ITU, the member countries, allocate the frequency bands to their telecom service providers generally in line with ITU identified bands. Being a sovereign country, they can otherwise also decide. It is important to use harmonized frequency bands as identified by ITU for worldwide interoperability and development of ecosystem of equipment and devices supporting those bands. This brings economy of scale. The standard making bodies such as Third Generation Partnership Project 3GPP specifies the frequency bands supported by the technology developed by it, be it for 2G, 3G, 4G or 5G, out of the bands identified by ITU. So not all the bands identified by ITU will be utilized at once. The technology will get evolved and those frequency band will be used accordingly. So ITU in its WRC19, World Radio Communication Conference 19, in this conference only they identify the newer frequencies bands. So this was held during 28th October to 22nd November 2019, and in this meeting, WRC 19 meeting, additional bands were identified to enable 5G deployment, and these new bands are in the range of 24 to 27 GHz, 37 to 43 GHz, 45 to 47 GHz, 47 to 48 GHz, and 66 to 71 GHz. So in total, 17.25 GHz of spectrum has been identified in WRC 19 meeting. If you compare this with earlier allocation, earlier identified frequency bands for IMT, it was only 1.9 gigahertz. So more than 8 times additional spectrum has been allocated to enable 5G deployment. When a spectrum is allocated by WRC, ITU in its WRC meeting, that doesn't mean that it is getting allocated for 5G or 4G. They allocate it for IMT, International Mobile Telecommunications, and those SDOs, Standard Development Organizations, they specify which frequency bands will be supported by the technology they are developing for 2G, 3G, 4G and 5G. Let us look at frequency bands specified by 3GPP for 5G. So 3GPP in its release 15 and 16 specifications have specified supported band for 5G. It has specified two frequency ranges, frequency range 1, FR1, and frequency range 2, FR2. FR1 frequency bands are low and mid band, and it ranges from 410 MHz to 7.125 GHz. Existing 2G, 3G, and 4G systems are already working in these bands. So operators have to reform these frequency band for using it for 5G deployment. In FR1 band, in frequency range 1, in FR1, three new bands are identified by 3GPP. They are N78, N77, and N79. Band N78 is gaining momentum, and most 5G systems being deployed in the world are using N78 band. FR2 frequencies are high band. It ranges from 24.25 GHz to 52.6 GHz. In this range, four bands have been specified by 3GPP. They are N258, N257, N261, and N260. This table taken from 3GPP specification gives all the frequency band supported by 5G new radio. So they are known as NR operating band, new radio operating band. Its nomenclature is like N1, N2, N3, and so on. So this table includes all the existing bands as well as the new bands identified by 3GPP for 5G working. The bands in FR1 are generally FDD, that is, their duplex mode is FDD, frequency division duplexing, and some of the bands are also TDD, time division duplexing. But in millimeter wave side, the four band which we saw are only TDD, time division duplexing. Some of the frequency bands are only for downlink. They are known as SDL, supplementary downlink. And some of the frequency bands are only for uplink, supplementary uplink, SUL. We can see these bands. Click next on top right menu for proceeding to the next module of the course.